So guys, in this video we are going to see this command injection tutorial via this TryHackMe room called injection. So you can go to TryHackMe and sign up for an account and search for injection in the activities. You will get this injection room, walkthrough of OS command injection, demonstrate OS command injection and explain how to prevent it on your servers. Okay, now before this we need to connect to the network. It's using this OpenVPN. You don't need to worry about this OpenVPN installation, it is default in the kernel Linux. All you have to do is go to this access machines and click on this OpenVPN. You will get this website, and what you have to do is you need to download this configuration file. So using this OVPN configuration file, you need to connect to their servers to access these machines. So I have already downloaded this configuration file. So you need to run this OpenVPN as a root user, sudo OpenVPN. And you need to say the open OVPN file name, and you need to hit enter. Now enter the password for your root user and it will be connected in few minutes, less than a minute. Now we need to join this room. I have already joined the room and we need to deploy this server. So let me deploy this. Before I want to explain something, we all know Linux commands, right? Let's say pwd, which shows the print working directory, and ls. Okay, it shows some output, and let me go to the desktop. So here what I can do is I will say pwd and I put the semicolon, and if I put the another command, then this two will be executed as a separate commands. And as you can see, first pwd command has been executed and the output is displayed. And after this semicolon, this shell interpreter will identify that this command has been completed, and then the next command will be executed. You can see the ls output here and pwd output here. So if any web server that's giving this option for searching the files or executing any commands, and if you put the semicolon and you can type another command to display the output. So this is where when the web server is poorly coded. So let's this is called command injection. We can inject the commands in the text box or any other variable field we have in the web server. So so I think the machine is deployed. So as you can see, the IP address of this machine is this IP address. Let me copy it and say export to let's say a name, a new variable, say injection is equals to this value. If I say IPA, so we will get the new interface, that is tunnel 0 adapter, and this tunnel is connected to this OpenVPN, the TryHackMe website. And I got the new IP address, which is the class A IP address 10.9.179.180, class A private IP address. So what I can do is I can say just ping dollar injection. So as you can see, I am successfully pinged to this this web server. Let me copy this one and let me open this in the Firefox browser to see anything valuable. So in meantime, I will run the GoBuster tool on this URL. To restore any directories. So first, before that, sorry, I pasted two times. So it says directory search. I think we no need to do the directory brute forcing. So let's directory search in this. I have explained all this theory here. I can just say completed. You can also read this description if you want to. So this is a command injection, and you can put the semicolon and then execute the next command. This is called a blind command injection. So the source code of this web server has been displayed here in a screenshot. You can see get username. So this is let's say temp. So as you can see, this so this temp value has been stored in the username variable, and it is being sent to the PHP backend. As you can see here, the username get of username retrieves the value we typed in this username field, that is the temp. So it is, it will get the temp value, and then it will just grep for the file name or the just exact syntax of this exact file name, and then executes this command. And then if there is null output, it will say that username has not found on the system. So let me try to search. Since this is the directory search, it's searching for any directories. Let's say hc passwd. So user hc passwd is not found on the system. Maybe it's searching for a username. Okay, we don't care about this directory search, because we can put the semicolon and then execute our command. So you can all read this description if you want. I am just explaining directory. So I need to ping the box with 10 packets. What is this command? So I already told you, we can type the temp semicolon and then let's say ls. As you can see, even though my temp was not found, this ls has been found on the system. So that's why since ls found on the system, it says temp ls has found on the system. It is considering whole output as a found on the system, because it will get any value on executing this command temp comma temp semicolon ls. So even though temp gives an error, and the ls gives some output, right? So that output will be matched in this ls block, and then it says this user was found on the system. So I can simply put say ping with 10 packets minus c count, c for count, and 10, and this IP address. Okay, ping the box with 10 packets. Okay, without IP address. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, now my answer is correct. And redirect the box Linux kernel to the file on the web server. What is the Linux kernel version? So we need to find the Linux kernel version. I can say semicolon, and then I can say this as uname minus a. Okay, uname a was not found on this. So we need to say, we need to store it in a file, and you need to display the search for that file, uname minus a greater than. So redirecting to let's say log69.txt. Okay, okay, I have understood now. Our output has been stored in the log69.txt. I can say log69.txt. Since not found on the system, they are redirect the Linux box kernel to a file on the web server. What is the Linux kernel version? So, okay, up to now we have seen just executing commands here. Now I will show you how to get the reverse shell from this command execution. Let me go to pentest monkey and reverse shell. So before that, I want to identify which programming languages have been installed on the system. I can say which Python So Python has been found on the system. Okay, that's fine. And go to this reversal cheat sheet, and you can see the Python reversal code. So you need to copy this. So this will is like similar to netcat, and you will see this socket module and subprocess module in the Python section. No need to worry about this. So let me paste it in here. So we need to modify some changes. We need to modify the IP address to our Kali Linux machine, which is our tunnel 0 adapter, which is this IP address. So let me change this. So this is, you can also, this is not only related to command injection, you can just get a reversal from this command injection vulnerability. So I think that's all for this. I'm happy with this 1234 port. Let me copy this entire one, and before executing that reversal, we need to set up a listener. I think this netcat would be sufficient. And now let's use the semicolon and space and copy paste my entire Python socket programming code to get a reversal. Now if I submit this, and if I go to my terminal, and you can see we have got the shell. All right, we have got the shell, and what they have asked is kernel version. Now it's very comfortable to execute our commands. What is the kernel version? 4.4. This one is the version. We paste it, and there you go. Enter the root into the output and review the alert. What type of alert do you get? All right. Let me copy this IP address. So I have opened in an again newly, and let's say root, and let's see, root was found on the system. What type of alert do you get? I need to say success. Enter www data into the input and say the alert www data. www data has also been found on the system. Let's say success. Enter your name. Okay, my name is Nikhil, and we got the error. So now we will see the active command injection. That is a similar way without this execute command, but we will use the pass through command. It's also same like execute command. And you can see the description here, and you can try to identify whether it's a Linux system or the Windows system. All you need to type is, you can differentiate between the Linux system and Windows system is using ifconfig. If you got any output like found on the system, it means our server is in the Linux. So ifconfig was not. Okay, let me type ipconfig then. Maybe this. So ipconfig were also not found. Let me type. Okay, who am I command? Who am I is in the Linux, and who am I was found on system. Maybe ifconfig the nettools repository has not been installed. So it's a Linux system. We have confirmed with that this is the Linux system. We can also try all these commands as well. What is the strange text file in the website root directory? So we got this one, let's say ls, and we have got this text file drpepper.txt. Let's say cat drpepper.txt. Okay, it says I love Dr. Pepper. So we need to type drpepper.txt. So my answer is correct. How many non-root or non-service non-daemon users are there? So to find out this, you need to go to the home folder. In that, you will find the number of users, cd home. So in that home folder, you will find the home directories of all the users available. Am I wrong? Okay, I think there are zero users. So let me type in zero. Okay, my answer is correct. There are no zero users. You can also check this etc/passwd file for the any non-root users. You will see from the ending what user this is this app running as. Okay, I need to say who am I. Let me type who am I and say www data. And I need to execute this www data and hit enter. Okay, my answer is correct. So what is the user's shell set as? So what you can do is, to find out the user shell, we need to read the etc/passwd file. In that, our user is www data, and you need to see the contents of the shell from where the shell is executing for this www data. Let's say cat etc/passwd, and so there you go, guys. We have all the services and the root user. You can see from the last, there are no non-root users, right? There is only SSH daemon service. And you can see www data has encrypted password, user ID, group ID, and some comment, and the home folder where www and the user bin, sbin, system bin, no login. So this is the directory where the shell is starting for this www data. So what version of Ubuntu is running? Okay, this is you need to find using lsb release minus a. So lsb release minus a gives this information about the Linux distribution. You can also find out this lsb release, and there are some like these modules like lsbrk and lspc, lscpu, etc., which relates to the system information. So we have got this 18.04.4. Let me copy this. So print out the mod d, what favorite beverage is shown. Okay, mod d is the message of the day. I don't know what's the directory exactly the mod d. Let me locate this mod d. So update mod d default mod d header. So let me copy this one. Let me see whether this is the exact path or not. So it is directory. Now let me see this header file. Okay, this is the, I think this is header. If not, let's give it a try. Dr. Pepper makes the world taste better. So print out the mod favorite beverage is shown. So beverage. So Dr. Pepper may be the beverage because we have the two first word consists of two alphabets. Let me try this. Dr. Pepper. Okay, I thought it's a doctor name. So we need to get the flag. Good work getting this far. You have completed the walkthrough. Exploit the vulnerability and get the flag. For this, you can exploit either both are vulnerable. So I think we need to do this privilege escalation. Okay, let's do this privilege escalation. Not a problem. Okay, need to first let us review any other commands we can execute as the root user. Okay, I will explain this when privilege escalation. We need to get the tty shell and also so I will discussing about this in the privilege escalation topic, how to get the privilege escalation to get the root flag. So don't worry about this. This tutorial is only about this active command injection or just command injection. I hope you have understood. We can just the main concept you need to understand this. If you have any the command injection possibilities, you need to execute this reverse shell for better convenience. So you can go to this Pentest Monkey cheat sheet, and you need to find the what programming languages have been installed on the web server. say Python and PHP and etc. If the PHP, you need to modify the IP address to your Kylinux machine so that the connection will connect to your Kylinux machine. And then we need to execute the reverse shell. Then we get the shell and we can comfortably execute the commands. You can see there are a lot of reverse shell cheat sheets are there. So don't worry about this all reverse shells and cheat sheets. In the network pen testing and privilege escalation, after those sections, you will get crystal clear clarity about all these.